मूढ़जहि धनागम तृष्णा पुरुषबुद्धि मनसि वितृष्णा यल्लभसे निजकर्मोपातम् वित्तं तेन विनोदयचित्तम् भज गोविंदम् भज गोविंदम् गोविंदम् भज मूढ़मते। Now what is the second trap? The second trap is worldly wealth. What does Bhagwan say here? Hey Moodha, again the Moodha term continues. O fool, O deluded one, Jehihi, give up. What should I give up? Trishnam, the craving. Craving for what? Dhana, Agama, Trishnam, Jehihi. Give up the craving for wealth. Then what am I supposed to do? Kuru sadbuddhim, vitrishnam manasi sadbuddhim kuru. Become dispassionate, give up all these cravings, and then instead develop sadbuddhi, right thinking. Develop right thinking about life. So Bhagwan, does it mean that I should not earn any wealth? No, I did not say that. Yallabhase nija karma upatam. Whatever money you earn legitimately with your hard work, with that vittam tena vinodaya chittam, you entertain yourself, you fulfill all your needs with your legitimate efforts, you fulfill all your needs, that much you earn. But let not you be trapped in this craving for wealth. Now let us analyze this problem of earning wealth. See, the Lord has given each and every person some talent, and earning wealth is also a talent. It's an ability. Some rare few are blessed with the ability to generate wealth. So what are we supposed to do when we are blessed with a talent by the Lord? Should we use it or should we not use it? We should definitely use it. Each and every person is blessed with a particular talent. So, whatever talent you are blessed with, you must use it fully. But the only difference is, it should not be used for selfish purpose. It should be used for the service of all. So, in Hinduism, we have normally this four castes or varnas. What are they? Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishyas and Shudras. So Brahmanas are the people who are blessed with the ability to think. That talent of thinking deep into a subject, clarity in thinking. Remember, that talent also is a blessing from the Lord. And who are these Kshatriyas? Kshatriyas have this talent of leading, of executing, of administering. They are called Kshatriyas. Again, that talent also comes from the Lord. And then this business class people or the Vaishyas, they are blessed with the talent of generating wealth. And then the Shudras, who are blessed with the talent of what? Physical labor. So everyone in the society is blessed with one or the other talent. So what are we supposed to do? We are supposed to make use of the talent as best as we can, not forgetting that this talent comes directly from the Lord. It is not my talent, it is just flowing through me. So what are we supposed to do? We have to make use of this talent. Now the singer, she has been blessed with such a wonderful voice. So because of which we all had this golden opportunity to fill our hearts with devotion, isn't it? In the same way, any person who is able to generate wealth. Remember, here we are, Bhagwan does not criticize generating wealth or earning wealth. What is being criticized is, you generate wealth for yourself, then that is a sin. Generate wealth, sufficient wealth. Even in Upanishad also it is said, You generate wealth. But after your needs are met, use that wealth in the service of others. Now, normally what happens is, when we live in this world, we find that people are getting trapped in this earning wealth, in this process. Now, why are they trapped? They are trapped because unknowingly they develop a philosophy that money is happiness. Once a person makes a philosophy, then he starts living that philosophy. So the question is, what is your philosophy about life? Once you tell your philosophy, I can tell you how you will spend your time, how you will plan your life. Suppose a person says, money is everything. And superficially, when we see the world, we find that yes, a rich person is respected. A rich person has got the freedom. He has power. A rich person is able to buy those things which he desires. So we find that a rich person is very happy. So naturally, for a superficial observer, it is natural that he may develop this philosophy that wealth is happiness. But here Bhagwan says, Vitrishna manasi sad buddhim kuru. Think little deeper. Can the wealth really make you happy? Is it possible? If this equation holds good, then all the rich person must be very, very happy. And all the poor people must be miserable. That is not what we find. Instead, what we find is just the reverse. In most cases, isn't it? In one of the Sanskrit Subhashitam, it is said, earning wealth is a pain. Protecting the wealth is also another pain. And spending is also another pain. So really speaking, the rich people cannot be happy. There is a Subhashitam. There is always this fear when you have money, isn't it? Another very famous this thing is, what we really want, money cannot give. For example, I want good sleep. Can I purchase it? No. I want good hunger. Can I purchase it? No. I want good health. I can buy medicines. But you can't purchase health. So many things which you really need in life, money cannot buy. It is said, the happiest person is the one who is contented. And therefore, he is the really richest man. Who is the richest man in life? The one who is contented. The one who says, enough. This is enough for me. Such a person is considered to be the richest man. Suppose there is a rich person who has got lot of desires, though he is already rich, he is still greedy. Trishna is there, craving is there. Then he is called a poor rich man. Materially, though he is rich, he still remains poor. So here Bhagwan says, give up this craving. This craving is something which will take away your peace of mind. Don't think that money can give you security. What can give you security is only the Lord. Though you may have yoga kshemam vahamyaham, but remember, the real yoga kshema is taken care by the Lord alone. Money cannot give you yoga kshemam. The perfect yoga kshemam can be done only by the Lord. So therefore, bhaja govindam.